Welcome to the DCC Museum.
Hi, and welcome back at the museum. Today's topic is the donations of portables that we received in the last year at the museum. The first portable donated by Tieme Kuiper, who was the lead engineer working on the DCC 170. The middle one is the DCC 175, donated by Abraham Hogedorn, the architect working on the DCC project. And the last one is today's topic. It's a donation that we received, the DCC 170, by Angelique Paulussen. Angelique Paulussen was the public media affairs manager during the DCC era in 1992 to 1995 at Philips. She was the wingwoman of director and CEO Jan Timmer and flew all over the world with Gijs Weerts to promote DCC. This is her story.
Whenever we receive a donation, we always try and put the provenance behind it. If possible, this starts by signing the player. Here are some custom examples signed by the earlier mentioned Tieme Kuiper, Bram Hogedorn, Angelique Paulussen, David Hill and Gijs Weerts.
Hello, my name is Angelique Paulussen and I've been working on two sides of the fence. I started in the music industry around the digital audio tape controversy and then moved over and started to work with Philips. When I started at Philips, I worked directly with Jan Timmer. Jan Timmer used to be the CEO of Polygram and he well understood the importance of having a hardware and a software solution all in one. Philips, of course, had the experience with the VHS video cassette, and that basically failed because there was no support among the movie industry. And this time, Jan wanted to make sure that this new technology immediately was supported by the music industry. And that's why he asked me to start working at Philips. So when I came to Philips with my music background, it was quite unusual. The people who were working there were very skilled, very technical and completely unaware of the issues that were playing out in the music industry. For starters, there was already a language barrier. In the music industry in the 90s, it was quite usual to use the F word. In Philips, every time the F word was used, in particular by a music industry executive, that was a serious offense. Philips sent me together with a technician to the music industry to promote DCC. And it was quite funny because I remember our first demonstration of DCC to EMI in Los Angeles, and we had a demo type with us. And when we arrived in Los Angeles, the demo DCC machine had completely broken down. So I was there with Gijs Weerts, the DCC technician, and myself, and we basically talked for an hour and then wanted to show them the DCC. We showed them the DCC machine, but it couldn't play, of course. So we managed to convince the music industry by playing a CD, which we told had the same quality as the DCC. I still can't believe they fell for it, but they did. We also needed to go to all the big music shows, which was, of course, a great pleasure for the engineers and myself, and we would see top artists. But one experience was really funny when we went to a classical concert of a very well-known performer, and one of our top technicians managed to sit on the front row. And when the music got too loud, it was too embarrassing for words, he started to do this. Well, that's the last time we got invited to any of these great shows.